David Letterman's the top 10 of what gets on Pastor Jason's nerves. No, here we go. But as you can see, I'm not David. I'm just Chad Simon. All right, number 10. All right. Students doing homework during youth group. I mean, you guys don't have like the problem doing it at home? Come on, fellas.
Okay, so we're talking about the Great Commission. Jessica. What are you doing?
Nothing.
Let me see that. Let me see it. What are you doing?
Oh, you're in trial.
More information. All 10th graders should try and learn. We're doing homework in youth group. Where's your notes about the lesson?
Right here.
Let's see.
No.
That's what I thought. What are we doing homework youth group? What are you doing over there?
Algebra.
Algebra. What's that say about the Great Commission? You don't know. What did I just read to you about the Great Commission?
Number 9 in our top 10 list. Alright, here we go, Paul. Listen to this. Youth taking bathroom trips during the service. I mean, usually you think it's the old people that have the little small bladder, but I think, I don't know, these little kids, I don't know. Here we go.
As much as we don't want it, we need to have discipline in our life. What is this? People going to bathrooms? Can't wait till afterwards? When you have discipline as a boxer, you train the way you should.
Youth not cleaning up the Soulfire Cafe. I mean, ladies, you have a nice place. I mean, gentlemen, I know you guys aren't really the forte of cleaning up, but I think we can do something here. Let's go. Let's try it out.
What am I going to do about these teenagers?
Number 7, trying to get the student's attention during service. I mean, ladies and gentlemen, you understand how kids get out of hand. I mean, Paul, just take a look at this clip. Here we go. You can only move as
fast as who's in front of you. Everyone has heard the saying, reading is knowledge, and knowledge is power.
Who's in front of you? Number 6. Ooh, this is a dandy. Here we go, Paul. Right here. Alright. Leaving the youth pastor to clean up the van after a youth trip. Cause I can sniff, I can see. Cause I can sniff, I can see.
Cause I can sniff, I can see. And I can count up really high. Christian Foster. I don't remember ever getting him. For him. That's nasty. Sorry, Merle.
Number 5 on her countdown, Paul. Here we go. The boys taking off their shoes and the girls spraying perfume in the van. Number 4, here we go. Oh, smacking gum during service. It can't get much more annoying. I mean, seriously, people. I can't even say anymore. Take a look at this clip.
Let me see the wrapper.
Listen up. Obviously, reading the Bible, taking it apart, trying to understand different things from other people. The question is, do we want to learn from other people?
Number 3, here we go. Being a distraction during worship service. All right. Ladies, I know you like to talk to the guys, but I think you can wait until after service. Here we go. questions during a lesson, I think I'd be a little upset. Just a little.
The third thing that we need is strength and endurance. Josh.
Do chickens have large talons?
Does that have anything to do with the lesson?
No.
Then pay attention. Don't ask me that kind of stuff.
I want to know.
We get a big drum roll here, Paul. Here we go. And our final on the top 10. The youth pastor having to repeat a Bible verse. Maybe 5, 10, 15 times. Ladies and gentlemen, that is unacceptable. Take a look at this clip. And here we go.
Nothing but that funky gospel ballad.
Time what?
Luke 9, 23. Page 1017.